Hey, Janet. So the chief has entrusted you with my assignment, hey? I hope it didn't interfere with your weekend plans. Anyway, he told me to call you and fill you in on it. You remember the murder that happened a few years back that was never solved? The one at Painscreek where the ex-mayor's wife was killed? Well, the property's being auctioned off soon, so we don't have much time to dig up anything that's relevant to the case. So, see what you can find. Hopefully it'll be something worth publishing. Anyway, take care. I'll see you on Monday. Bye.
Hi, this is Steven. I just wanted to make sure the package was sent. Again, I'm currently at Anne's courtyard. Any extra info you have would be much appreciated. Thank you very much. Talk to you later. This is Oliver Gibson. I just wanted to thank you for letting me borrow your toolbox and shovel. I'm currently out of town for a few days, and I didn't get the chance to return it yet. In the case you need them, it's currently sitting in my photo lab. Ask Mrs. Patterson for my spare key.
Hello again, Miss Roberts. How are you doing? What should we talk about today? The nurses have notified me that you haven't been eating your meals. Is there something wrong with the food? We know that currently this is a rough time for you. Your father has been asking for you. He wants to know if he can talk to you.
Thank you. received a letter from the NMB investigation firm regarding the use of the RRF funds. I need you to call me. Henry, we really need to talk. Please call back. What's going on, Henry? Why aren't you returning my calls? This is really important.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. 1995. I met Andrew in the evening at his house. He was hallucinating when we met, saying that he's seen Sophia everywhere, that he's a sinner, that he should die. But I didn't mean to kill him. My hands are still shaking. June 30th, 1995. Dr. Johnson came. He was surprised to see me. He tried to justify, saying it wasn't his fault, that he was only carrying the baby and had nothing to do with Sophia's death. When I revealed the truth about Magdalene, his face turned white. He didn't expect anyone to know the truth. He deserved to die. July 19, 1995. Just like the doctor, Vivian came alone. Instead of feeling guilty, she called Sophia a bitch who destroyed everything she had. I did not feel any sign of remorse, feeling of guilt, or repentance from her at all. So I gave her time to express herself, and then I killed her. It's all over now. Why am I not at peace? There's this nosy investigator in town. I thought that if I led him to believe that Bernard killed Vivian, he just might believe it. But I made the mistake of trying to mislead him. Now, he's suspecting me of being the killer. He has to die.
Thank you.